IT leaders have no shortage of priorities to balance as they position their organizations for resiliency and growth. And one of the hot spots for growth and transformation is the edge. Hi, everybody. Jim Malone with IDG here, and welcome to this podcast series sponsored by Lumen Technology. In this episode, our focus is on edge services and applications. And with us to talk about that is Chris Smith, Vice President of Platform Applications with Lumen Technology. Hey, Chris, welcome. Tell us about your role at Lumen.
I have a very interesting role. I am in charge of a number of different product portfolios inside of Lumen. Think about all of the things that we would have deployed in an appliance-based fashion that we endeavor to make software and that we plan to distribute as a capability on our cloud edge. Those things include portfolios like security and SD-WAN and software-based networking and UC and enterprise-based CDN. And all of those things we are redefining as software-based experiences on the platform for amazing things.
Excellent. Thanks, Chris. We're really delighted that you could be with us. Our research here at IDG points out that reduced network latency, it's one of the big drivers for edge initiatives. We looked at this in our State of the Network survey this year. That means organizations need to deliver high bandwidth applications and services at a global scale. That can be a big challenge. So, Chris, let's dive into some of the challenges you're seeing to deploying applications and services at the edge. What are some of those top challenges?
Well, the edge as a concept is new and old. Conceptually, it is cloud infrastructure or hosting infrastructure in a more distributed fashion. And the challenge is there really isn't a standard. So when we're talking to customers or we're looking at vendors that want to distribute applications and our infrastructure, everyone comes with their own unique set of requirements. What hardware do they require? What server capacity do they need for their application to perform? Which virtualization layer are they familiar with? Do they have their own orchestration platform? And are these applications going to be customer facing? And what would be the network requirements around that? So there isn't really quite a standard yet. And to crowdsource different applications or software or WAN technologies onto a cloud edge, we're still at the point where it requires thoughtful design and consulting to deploy modern applications in a distributed fashion. So the challenge, I think, mostly is we're still very early days.
Thanks, Chris. That's interesting about the emerging standards. That may be because the edge is kind of seen as an emerging technology. So talking about those emerging standards, how does that translate into helping enterprises evaluate what to look for in an edge platform? And I have a second part of that question that deals with SASE, that is Secure Access Services. But let's deal with part one here. How do those emerging standards translate into helping enterprises evaluate what to look for in an edge platform?
Well, like I said, there really isn't a standard right now. So, you know, the way that we deal with it is very much with our IT services consulting arm. We need to do a lot of listening, and it starts with the physical. You know, usually customers will come with a point of view on, like I said, what sort of hardware they need, what sort of virtualization, how mature they are in their technology stack. And I mean, the edge for us, we've sort of thought about it from a use case perspective. We have customers that will come to us and really all they need is a modern data center that is closer to where their application needs to be consumed. And really what's driving the edge use case is these applications need to be closer to where they need to be consumed. They need a very low latency experience to perform. And I can give you some examples when we get into it. So we'll have customers come to us and really all they need is they need a data center where they can bring in their racks and they can bring in their gear and they need to plug it into a network. And then if you go up a layer, we have customers that really don't want to be bothered with the capital outlay of buying bare metal and buying hardware because it's more and more commodity. So they're looking for the data center and the hardware layer and plugging that into a network. Then you go up a layer and you'll have customers that want us to deal with the virtualization and the operating system. Mm-hmm. So it's sort of a building block. And like I said, mm-hmm. every one of our customers is coming with a different point of view. So we do a lot of listening at this point as these standards are being formed. And as they're being formed, SASE has provided sort of a framework or a North Star for what a modern, secure WAN will look like in the future. And if you haven't heard of SASE, SASE is it's a term that Gartner penned in 2019. And it was more of an idea than anything tangible or a product. And if you read the report, I read it in 2019, I've read it several times since. What it says is you as a networking and security industry, whether it's the service providers or the software vendors, you've done a really poor job of making this simple for your customers. You deliver network-based things and security-based things and SD-WAN as single stovepipes or single SKUs and disparate commercial offers with different operating models. And then you expect that the enterprise or your customers, they take all of this and they deal with the complexity themselves. And we, Gartner, think that isn't acceptable. And then the report goes on to say, you know, you enterprises, you should expect more from your community. You should expect things that sound like networking and SD-WAN and security to come integrated as a single commercial offer and a single operating model in a single pane of glass. And you should look for providers that can bring that all together for you and to make it simple. And when I read the report in 2019, I chuckled a little bit because while the idea was sound, what Gartner was telling customers to go and buy didn't exist in the world. It was a unicorn. but as this space has evolved and as you know, many of the providers in the space have continued to innovate, everyone's listened. So things that used to be physical appliances are now turning into software, and companies that build WAN technologies and security technologies are bringing those things together into a single SKU. And SASE is now being born, and it's a journey, not an event. What's interesting about SASE and the Cloud Edge is one of the foundational frameworks for SASE is it needs to be more distributed because employees or end users of these applications, they're not just going to be working in offices anymore. They could be at home, they could be in a coffee shop, they could be anywhere. And consumption of applications and the network access to those applications needs to be much more distributed than it was in the past. And the Cloud Edge is the perfect platform to deploy these new SASE concepts and technologies.
Yeah, that seems like, Chris, the Lumen platform was designed to deliver application services using SASE. I'm going to guess that was on purpose. That was purposeful.
It was a happy circumstance. So really the Lumen Edge, it was designed to solve a single customer problem. It's about the application and the customer's application experience. So, you know, kind of where this formed for us a couple of years ago, we started having customers come to us and they wanted to have conversations around their application experiences. And I'll give you, I can't share the customer name, but I'll give you an interesting use case. We had a very large retail customer come to us and say, hey, we've built this really cool facial recognition application tied to some, you know, some cool video camera technology that we developed. And here's how we plan to use it. We want to put it in all of our stores And when folks come into our stores, we're going to do a couple things with this technology. You know, if we know that Tommy or Susie on a Friday night usually comes in for, you know, a six pack of Heineken, for example, when we see them come in, we can push an offer onto their phone and entice them to buy something. So that's use case number one. The more interesting use case, though, was our customer told us we've developed a technology that we believe can help us reduce shoplifting. This facial recognition platform can look at body language and intent and things like perspiration. And we know we can predict within, you know, a certain percentage of accuracy that, you know, somebody is predisposed to, you know, put something in their bag or put something in their purse. And in a retail business, it's already very thin margin. So if we can shave a point or two or improve by a point or two the margin of the company by reducing shoplifting, that is real money. But here's the challenge. We tried to distribute this facial recognition application in all of our stores, and it didn't make sense, right? They need to be connected, and they need to be sort of self-aware, and it didn't scale. And we tried to run them in the public cloud, and the latency was too great, and the applications didn't perform. You know, when Tommy or Susie, we didn't push the coupon for the six pack of Heineken until they had already left the store. So we need a different way to distribute our applications closer to our stores in a sub 5 millisecond performance. And so that's kind of how our Cloud Edge was born. And if you don't know this about Lumen, Lumen is one of the largest data center providers in the world. We have a lot of physical infrastructure and a lot of real estate. And some of that real estate, there are buildings that we call COs that we've used, you know, for the last 20 or 30 years to support legacy copper-based voice, you know, for residential customers or for small businesses. And that part of our business that use case is kind of going away. So we repurposed, or in the process of repurposing, about 100 of these COs, and we're turning them into cloud data centers to support. And this turns into our cloud edge infrastructure. And this is where we'll host those application experiences we just talked about. And part of my job is developing platform applications is to use this platform, this cloud edge investment, to develop our software-based security and WAN SASE deployment, and we're working on that now.
Chris, I wanted to touch on kind of another angle, and that is, how should software vendors think about service delivery on the edge? Does it change the approach that network and security vendors will use when they deliver, you know, SD-WAN or network security products?
Very, very much so. So, you know, if you think about how we would have worked with, you know, WAN or security vendors, you know, in the past, you know, let's pick it, you know, whether it's Palo Alto or Juniper or Fortinet or VMware, all of those companies are companies that we would work with to develop solutions or offers in the market. And, you know, the way it used to work was, you know, they would build an appliance, let's call it SD-WAN or a firewall or some sort of router or gateway. And we would put it in a lab for a bunch of months and we'd test it. And then we'd take those physical devices and deploy them into data centers and plug networks in them. And folks like me and my team, we would wrap those capabilities with commercial offers and quote the cash, and we would teach sales how to sell them. That's the old way to build products. Anymore, the network and security vendors that we partner with, they are moving away from traditional appliance-based delivery, and they're now software companies, right? They don't want to build appliances. That's hardware, and that actually that devalues the company because it's commodity anymore. So they just want to build software. That's what they're good at. So they need a place to host their applications. Sometimes it'll be in the public cloud. Sometimes it'll be in a private data center. And we believe that we will provide a better experience when those sorts of applications are hosted in our cloud edge. So we provide a place for those WAN and security vendors to host their software because they don't want to do it anymore. We're sort of the perfect platform for them. And the cloud edge will provide a distributed place for things like SASE and modern applications.
Chris, before we have to sign off, I wanted to ask you to kind of look ahead first. How do you see deployment of services at the edge evolving in the next, let's say, 12 to 18 months? What's got you excited looking ahead?
Well, we will all begin to create standards. We will all bring more things to market. I think what's most exciting about this for me is it's how it will benefit our customers. We are all focused on this whole SASE thing, which is bringing together, to my point earlier, numbers of different use cases, whether it's software-based networking or SD-WAN or different security capabilities. And we are bringing them together the way that Gartner sort of asked us to, into a single commercial offer, into a single operating model, and on the cloud edge in a better experience. And we will make consumption of networking and applications much, much simpler for enterprises and for our customers. So this is an exciting time to be in this space, and there'll be a lot of investment, and enterprises will definitely benefit.
Excellent. Thanks. With that, we are at the end of our time for this session. Chris Smith with Lumen, thanks so much. It's been a pleasure. We appreciate your insights and expertise here.
Happy to be here. Thanks for the time.
And thanks, everyone, for listening in. Now, for more information on edge computing, check out www.lumen.com. And with that, Jim Malone with IDG saying, thanks for tuning in, everybody.
This podcast is produced by IDG Communications Incorporated in association with its sponsor, Lumen.